When did it become acceptable for elected officials to lie to the public? As soon as officials were first elected. Asterisk, every person gets his own mud hut, and the mammoth will be equally shared by everyone. And we're not gonna throw stupid children off a cliff. Asterisk. I think people assume politicians are legally held a higher standard than they really are. I think people have become complacent with being lazy and ignorant to the point they didn't realize how bad things got until it was far too late, and not that things are terrible in a lot of places. They're finally starting to realize that politicians should be held to a higher legal standard than they are currently, and will force changes to match their expectations in order to avoid this shit happening again. Or at least I can hope. Lying has always been there. Blatantly lying is what's the hallmark of our current post-truth society. It has always been tolerated. Always. Why? I don't know. Because governing is very complex. It is easy to say, less taxes and more bread. Everyone wants to keep more and pay less. But there have to be compromises and choices. Most of these compromises and difficult decisions are kept away from the public, or the public doesn't pay attention. So when tough choices are made, we all are or act surprised. V. Ever since the alpha caveman didn't want to get clubbed to death. When did shame stop being a thing? John Profumo was a UK government minister who had been sleeping with a prostitute, who was also sleeping with a Russian trade attaché. When it came out, he resigned and retired from public life in shame. He did low-key charity work the rest of his life. Nowadays, a government minister gets caught in shady deals, gets sacked, and 6 months later they are back in government. Edit. I apologize to Christine Keeler. She was model and a showgirl, not a prostitute. Greater than he did low-key charity work the rest of his life. He was later awarded OB and sat next to the Queen at Thatcher's 70th birthday. Greater than Thatcher's 70th birthday 30 years later. There are two dominant parties that always win the right to be elected. Their support from the public always ranges in the vicinity of 50-50. Instead of people focusing their aggression on the poor job the elected parties do for the people. People versus government. People are instead directed to argue which party is better. So there are always about 50% of the people vehemently supporting some faction of the government. And there are never 100% of the people against the government. See how good it works for them? A two-party system is the biggest con of them all. Give us ranked choice voting. When was the first time we had elections? The first recorded elections are from the BCs. I think India in the 500 BCs. So, then? Since always, I'd argue that some degree of lying is required of a public official. There are white lies, half-truths, and fibs that need to be told to garner some perception of decision-making that a plurality will consent to. Politics is just an extension of social interactions applied in bulk. Nobody is socially truthful all the time. The question isn't about any lying. It's what kind of lies become unacceptable and when do those become acceptable? Correct. Especially when a politician says something and later on changes their answer. And then people freak out and call them out for lying. Excuse me, but did you know that people always change their opinion, and that means they are actually listening to what's going on in the world instead of staying in their shell and believing something that isn't true anymore? When people started catching on to the lying and decided to do nothing. The first mayor of Bedrock. When people started tolerating it. It always has been. They've been doing it since forever. You have to be historically illiterate or 14 years old to think this is new. I'm pretty sure to even want to be a politician you have to be some sort of narcissistic person. So lying comes with the territory. Well, they do it mainly because it's less damning for them to be caught lying than knowing about how wrong something is or why this thing is bad and doing it anyway. It's the same reason a lot of people in politics come off as very stupid. It's much better for them to be seen as dumb than known to be doing bad things purposely. They always lied. Being acceptable is up for debate. In the beginning, they lied but not directly. Obfuscations or subject changes kept them in the clear for a while. But as time went on, they grew comfortable in their place. No one had questioned their lies. Not enough to make them lose their job anyway. Plus, more lies always help. After a while, they thought to themselves, I'm getting older and I'm curious. How much can I get away with? Quote, it's no real risk to them. What with retirement coming up in a cushy place reserved down on K Street. Now they say what they think will distract. From what? Changes daily. The real question should be, how many lies are you willing to accept before you no longer accept them? If they told the truth, no one would listen. The truth requires some effort to explain in detail. When the public is hearing what it wants to hear. In the words of Andrew Lloyd Webber, way, way back many centuries ago, when they realized it works. I don't think there is a person alive who has never lied, or a person who ever lived long enough to do so. I think the lie being acceptable really depends on the lie and the reason behind the lie. Living in such a connected society just makes it more noticeable. Some people refuse to just say, I'm not able to speak on that at this time. I do believe there is sensitive information that the general public doesn't need to know about, such as military information or ongoing investigations. On the other hand, I wonder if they're so willing to lie straight-faced about things that are so easily verifiable as a lie. What else are they willing to hide that we should know? I wish I could still believe that some lies are really meant for our protection. But I'm too jaded after the last dot and I'm going to stop right there. I'm not going to name a party because that's just unproductive, and both main parties have proven that they can and do lie. I'm just going to say that I'm pretty jaded. Happy Cake Day. When the vast majority of the citizenry became ignorant and uneducated and fiercely proud of it, the first egalitarian semi-settled societies in the Pontic Caspian Steppe, probably. Anytime you see evidence of a council, so maybe 8,000 years ago, when revolts became serious, when we found out they were doing it, when was ancient Athens founded? Since the dawn of time. Since forever they are there to think we are in control. They need to lie to keep the dumb from freaking out and making things worse. It may not be right, but that is life. Since the first government was created, the leader must do, at minimum, two things. Get in power, and stay in power. Everything else is extra. Since the beginning of time, Plato's noble lie, the elite find it important to proliferate necessary falsehoods throughout society as a way to maintain social order, but it's really to keep them at the top. This is a given. People have always known about politicians being liars. If you ever genuinely trusted them or believed them without question, that says more about you than the masseur. Checks notes, never acceptable in practice since year 2500 BC, when Socrates was condemned to death. As soon as they realized blind voters exist, I mean they will vote only for their party regardless. The lies are only to boost morale. The problem is that there are not any immediate negative consequences for lying to the public. And not even many long-term consequences. If the lie isn't bad enough to cost them the next election, they've got no incentive to tell the truth. If there are no consequences to lying, they just say whatever helps push their political agenda, regardless of the truth. About 12,000 years ago when we first started society, like 2,000 plus years ago, it never was, is, or will be. That it happens does not mean it is acceptable. On the eighth day, politicians usually say half lies and half truths because if they lied fully on it would be easy to debunk the masseur. Well, Trump really doubled down on that by lying every time he speaks. Q. How do you know a politician is lying? A. Their lips are moving. At this point, it's the population's fault for expecting anything else. While it is tempting to cast blame on all sides and bemoan the low-level corruption that pervades all politics from every era, we are in a particularly bad patch of official dishonesty. I blame the 60s, which blew up the idea of truth and replaced it with individual perception, and the internet, which allows every moron to find like-minded people to share lousy ideas with. Politicians are byproducts of that, especially people like Trump and Bolsonaro. Since politics became a thing, when people wanted answers, the truth takes a while to explain and even longer to listen to and digest. A lie is quick. The year 1555, when William Phibb was elected to Parliament, he oversaw the passing of a statute allowing MPs to control their own correspondence with the public, which became known as fibbing. When it became acceptable for elected officials to lie to the public, the very moment people wanted something for free. There has never been anything for free, but people actually don't care as long as they can pretend they did not know, that they will make sure to not find out. Why is it okay? Because that's what most people ask for. It isn't acceptable, but people who tend to support a given person in government have a tendency to overlook their flaws and engage in whataboutisms in a way that deflects the question. The early Roman Senate, somewhere around 1770 for American politicians. When it's so partisan you can't really lose your supporters or win people over, you can say anything you want. Elected officials are just people. People lie. What you really are asking here is, why are people's bullshit detectors working anymore? Quote. The real answer is that people largely never had bullshit detectors. This shit has been happening forever. It's not acceptable. That's the shitty part, cause they still lie. It's not accepted, but it's expected. So you're lied to and promises are broken. You're thinking to yourself that you don't want this guy representing you anymore. But the process of removing him from power is tedious and convoluted. It's better to let his term run out and vote for someone else. But by then, so much other shit has happened that you're likely to have forgotten how betrayed you felt at the beginning. And so he wins again. When the public prefer a lie, it owns the libs. It's always been the case, I'm afraid, but I would love to see a law implemented where going against the manifesto on which you were elected is punishable by a long time in prison. There would have been plenty locked up in the last few years. On another note, it should be the law to hold an election if you defect to another party. One thing that came out of the Brexit discussions is that a lot of MPs seem to think that their constituents voted them in personally because they are all knowing and wise, rather than the truth, which is that most people vote red or blue and don't give two hoots whether their MP is a man or a cabbage. When we stopped holding them accountable for their actions, power corrupts. Absolute power corrupts absolutely. Few are immune. Some embrace it. Happy Cake Day. Ancient Egypt. Greece. Have you heard of wars? Not a lot of people getting along during the Monsieur. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.